Hi, I'm Rabbi Johanna Hershenson. Welcome to Words of Torah. This week we are in the second portion in the second book, the book of Exodus. The portion is called Parashat Va'era. In our ongoing narrative, Moses and Aaron are engaged in rounds of negotiations with Pharaoh to free the ancient Hebrew slaves. Unfortunately, the first round of negotiations did not go so well, and the burdens of the Israelites were increased. And while Moses is recommuning with God to sort of freshen up for the next round of negotiations, God says to Moses, promises to Moses, I, Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh, will bring you out from under the sievlot burdens of Egypt. And I want to draw attention this week to a Hasidic master, Simcha Bunim, who lived in the mid-1800s in Poland, who puns the word sivlot, burdens, from this verse with the Hebrew word savlanut, which means patience. Bunim says, even though the slavery was hard and crushing for the ancient Hebrews, nevertheless, they became accustomed to the bitterness. They bore the burden of their distress patiently. It's as if Simcha Bunim suggests that God's compassion is not aroused when the ancient Hebrews are enslaved in Egypt, but only when they seem to be accustomed to their slavery, when they cease to have the will to fight for their own dignity, their own right to take up space. Rabbi Simcha Bunim's teaching resonates in me this year, I think because of the events of the last week in our nation's capital, and I would even say in recent months since the election and the refusal of the current president to accept the results of the election despite plenty of validation from courts, secretaries of state, and many of them Republican appointees, that the election was in fact fair and valid. I can't help but pray that in the sight of the angry nihilistic mob we witnessed violating the halls of Congress, we Americans take note of the burdens we've become far too accustomed in bearing in the discourse of late in our country. Deliberate misinformation, hate speech, cynicism, false equivalency, disrespect, dismissal, grievance upon grievance upon grievance. As the Israelites needed to stir within themselves some discomfort, some end in their patience for their predicament, so do we if America is to return to the health we once shared as a nation, as a society, despite problems, despite shortcomings. But at least, right, there was a time in which we could speak to one another. I hope that our redemption from this broken time in our history unfolds in a reconciliation with facts and reason, in uplifting words rather than destructive words, in trust and hope in one another, in the passage of time, in our capacity to learn, to grow, to shift course when necessary, in shared standards of measurement for what is right and what is wrong, in a shared commitment to inclusion, equity, collaboration, and interdependence. May this prayer unfold in the way you and I behave the next time we come to gather to meet one another, in the way we speak and behave to our loved ones, in relationship with neighbors and with strangers. May this be our blessing. May this be our mission. May it be so. See you next week.